Gaming has been given a bad reputation over the last few years. Whether it is from the Gamergate controversy or that the older generations think that it makes us fat and lazy. But if the 2020 pandemic has taught us anything, it's that it's okay to spend your days playing video games during the pandemic. These are very stressful times for us, especially here in the United States. If you are deciding to turn on your console or PC and play online or alone, there's nothing to feel guilty about. And today, we're going to break down this video essay into multiple topics. First, we will be addressing the professional discussion of video games during quarantine, and then we will discuss why video games are so popular during the quarantine, and finally, I will discuss my personal opinion on gaming during the pandemic. I also wanted to say that all sources will be linked in the description below. There was a Times article by Matthew Galt stating that the gaming industry is facing a boom. The article states that gaming is up 75% on Verizon's networks, and a lot of people have started off their quarantine by learning how to make bread, while others decided to immerse themselves in video games when the outdoor experiences were limited. The same Times article also states that staying inside and playing video games may actually help the situation that we're in. There are multiple psychologists that state that video games have no negative outcomes as long as we are remaining physically active and eating healthy. And the last thing I'd like to touch on is that it's important that as long as we finish the tasks we are required to do, there should be no limits on the gaming time. And then my personal opinion on this Times article is that it describes it perfectly. I don't know if anyone else had taken any online courses over the summer, but when I was taking some courses, I set boundaries for myself. I know for a fact that if I hadn't set boundaries, I would game all day and not do any homework or save it up until the last minute. Despite us not knowing what the near future holds, we need to create structure for ourselves to remain organized while continuing to entertain ourselves during this time. There's another Times article by Sean Gregory that addresses parents of children that are gaming over the quarantine. A lot of adults have lost their jobs due to COVID-19 and therefore have a lot of time to spend at home. The article encourages parents to join their children if they can. In the article, the author plays 2K and talks about the NBA with her child as a way of bonding before returning to the uncertain and scary reality. This article gives a great example on how to bond with your children while we are all unoccupied, whether it is from being furloughed from work or school is canceled. For example, when the article talks about how the author played 2K with their child, they talk to their child about the NBA when they were growing up. While it may not be much, the parent is opening up to their child about their experiences when they normally would never hear it. In this portion of the essay, we will discuss what games were popular and why. In a New York Times article by Ahmad Khan, it discusses the craze that was Animal Crossing back in late March and April. The article discusses that Animal Crossing was popular due to there being no set end goal. There are goals, quote unquote, that the community has set, such as paying off your debt or trying to get the character KK Slider to your island to perform. But there is no official end goal to the game. It's a leisure game where the player could go at their own pace. After multiple discussions on text and Discord, I have come to the conclusion that the games we played over quarantine were popular for three reasons. Escapism, substitution for our regular daily tasks, and that it allowed us to be social while remaining socially distant. First, we will define escapism. Escapism is the action of seeking out distractions and/or relief from an unpleasant reality, which I think we can all agree that so far, all of 2020 has been an unpleasant reality. To give my personal experience with Animal Crossing, which is a good segue from my previous section, my friends all own the Nintendo Switch, while I do not. I never experienced the craze that was Animal Crossing. When Animal Crossing released, it was all my friends would talk about, in person and on Discord. So I wondered why was there so much hype about it. Watching my friends play, go to each other's islands, and perform their in-game tasks, I noticed that it provided a structure that they didn't have due to our school's closure, which one friend did confirm. He said that the menial tasks in-game are reminiscent of the tasks that we have in real life, such as scheduled events, the ability to customize your room and home, the small odd jobs, and spend hours doing what you wanted. When I had asked another friend why they thought Animal Crossing was so popular, one friend said escapism, which is in line with what my other friend had stated. It had filled a void that we missed out on due to the COVID-19 cancellations, and that it allowed players to escape from the harshness that was quarantine. Finally, another friend had stated that you were allowed to go visit your friends' islands and get rewards, play games, and have fun with each other while being separated, which is a good segue into the next topic of being social while being socially distant. Warzone became popular over the quarantine as well. I personally play Warzone with friends, and I decided to ask for their input on why it became so popular during the quarantine. They all stated the same two things. It filled the void of empty space, and it allowed the squad to be social when we couldn't hang out in person. It's definitely the same way for Among Us. And now moving on to our final topic, my personal experiences with gaming during the quarantine. And to start off, It is essentially for the same reasons why the previous games were so popular during the pandemic, and also I won't cover games like Among Us and Warzone because they were previously stated. I personally like single player games. A lot of the time, it is due to me not being able to afford Xbox Live or that my mic quality isn't that great, and yes, I am a console player. I still found myself joining some online lobbies or hopping on Discord with my friends. Especially this past summer, I played a lot of Minecraft, which became popular again this past year. Minecraft has been my favorite game since 2013 when I played it for the first time. I loved the creative freedom it gave the player. It was literally your world to mold, and in the 2020 pandemic, I spent a lot of time on my friend group's Minecraft realm, mining, crafting, creating some interesting farms using the redstone mechanic. I believe that this was the escapism factor coming into play. I was able to be outside when I couldn't in the real world. It allowed me to do what I wanted when I wanted, and it had always been my favorite part of Minecraft. While I did spend a lot of time playing Minecraft, I also spent a lot of time playing The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. It was like an interactive book where your actions can change the outcome of the story. The characters are all so charismatic and interesting, and it feels like everyone has their own stories. The combat is so fun, and the immense amount of quests helped fill the void of me losing my job due to the virus. The world itself is so interesting and it just wraps you in. While it may not be as beautiful as the world of Skyrim, especially with mods, being able to go anywhere with your indestructible horse, Roach, was always fun. There are hundreds of enemies to fight and learn about in your bestiary that it felt like a Dungeons & Dragons in a video game. So to wrap things up, gaming during quarantine is okay. Even the professionals say so. If you're a parent, play games with your child, bond with them, tell them stories of your childhood. Gaming allows us to remain social while being socially distant, and it helps us fill the voids that we had from school or work, and it allows us to escape from the harsh reality that is 2020. So, join an Xbox Live party, join a party on PlayStation, hop on Discord, squad up, load up your favorite game, and enjoy what you can during quarantine. Thank you.